Hello, my name is Insa Lange and I'm going to present to you our research on CT normalization by paired image-to-image translation for lung emphysema quantification. This work was a cooperation between the Institute of Medical Informatics of the University of Lübeck and the Department of Radiology and Nuclear Medicine of the University Hospital Schleswig-Holstein. The motivation for this research is the widespread chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, short COPD, which is causing alveolar obstructions called lung emphysema. In computed tomography of the chest, lung emphysema regions can easily be segmented by applying a threshold at less than minus 950 Hounsfield units inside the lung. Also from the segmentation, the emphysema index can be calculated by EI equals 100% times the emphysema volume divided by the total lung volume. The difficulty of the segmentation is its strong dependence on the CT parameters such as slide thickness and the filter kernel used for the reconstruction of the images from the raw data. For this work, we concentrated on the choice of the filter kernel. In the example below, you can see the extreme difference in emphysema segmentations and the calculated emphysema index of one patient due to the choice of the reconstruction kernel. Chest CTs of 71 patients reconstructed with both the smooth Siemens B20F and the sharp Siemens B80F filter kernel were available. For all reconstructions, the slide thickness was sampled to 1 mm. We used a unit architecture with 3 skip connections, max pooling for compression, and 128 feature maps in maximum compression for a pairwise image-to-image translation approach from B80F images to B20F images. Now coming to the results. In the upper row, you can see a paired test image slice of BATF before normalization, next to the corresponding B20F image slice and below the emphysema segmentations. Meanwhile, on this slide, the normalized BATF image slice shows a much higher agreement in image impression as well as segmentation with B20F image slice. The L1 distance was calculated by the mean distance per voxel and then taking the statistics over all 71 patients. Thus, the mean L1 distance from the BATF versus the B20F image was at 84.5 Hounsfield units and had a standard deviation of 11.7. And this could be reduced to a mean of 9.7 Hounsfield units with a standard deviation of 1.7 after normalization with our CNN approach. The great reduction of the difference to the B20F image after normalization of the B80F image becomes even more clear looking at these difference images. We evaluated our results of the emphysema segmentations with the Dias coefficient and compared those to the results of normalization with classical methods of the same data. The classical methods included a heuristic and a frequency-based normalization approach. Naturally, the mean dias of small segmentations can be expected to be lower than the mean dias of bigger segmentations with a higher emphysema index. Because of this, we are showing the overall statistics as well as the statistics only for patients with an emphysema index that is higher than 5%. The dias value for our CNN-based normalization approach in both statistical calculations shows a significant improvement compared to the BATF without normalization as well as both classical methods and reaches a mean of 0.76 with a standard deviation of 0.07 for emphysema indices higher than 5%. To examine the diagnostic value of the normalized images, we did a visual assessment of a random subset of 36 patients. For each patient, randomly either the original B20F or the normalized BATF image was shown to a radiologist as well as to a computer scientist specialized in medical imaging. Both experts have more than 5 years' experience. For rating the images, we suggested a system with possible scores of 0 to 5 from certain synthetic B20F to certain original B20F. The two pie charts to the left show the score distribution for the actual B20F and the actual normalized BATF images rated by the radiologist. Accordingly, the two charts on the right show the rating of the computer scientist. On first glance, the two charts of the computer scientist barely show any difference between the score distribution of B20F and normalized BATF images, whereas the distribution of the scores of the radiologists are suggesting that some features in the normalized images don't completely match up to those of the original B20F images. Nevertheless, neither the computer scientist nor the radiologist ever rated an image with a score of 0 or 5 to be certain whether it is an original B20F or a normalized B80F image. In addition, the radiologist found that the normalized B80F images overall meet diagnostic requirements. The key lessons to be learned from our work are, first, that a simple unit-based normalization outperforms classical methods. Second, that with the here used unit architecture, the normalized images can be of high quality and might be used for diagnostic purposes. And last but not least, that ratings for image impression or quality of medical images should always be performed by experienced radiologists on a radiological workstation. Thank you for your attention.